Mesdames.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the Pierre Fabre Foundation for the 8th Conference of the Observatory of the e-Santé in Southern Countries. Since it was created in 2016, the objective, the aim of the observatory has been to identify, promote and support innovative digital solutions in Africa and Asia that improve access to healthcare. So more than 200 programs were analyzed and documented, including with field surveys, and 45 projects have won awards, and they received financial support from the Pierre Fabre Foundation, thanks to an annual endowment of about 1 million euros. Today's conference will enable us to discover the four new prize winners who have come from Thailand, the Philippines, Rwanda and Zimbabwe, and they will present their project. The purpose of this conference is also to invite us to learn, to debate around a theme that crystallizes issues at the heart of digital health and global health. And this year, the theme is gender equity and the role of the digital world. An international panel of speakers coming from various countries will share their expertise and their best practices from the field. By gender, we mean the roles and representations which determine the behaviors, the activities, the expectations and opportunities of men and women in a given social-cultural context. So why this choice? Because gender is a determining factor for inequalities in health, both on its own and in association with other health-determining factors, like socioeconomic status, the age, ethnicity, disability, environment, and so on. The first principle of the WHO Constitution stresses that the organization must act not only to reduce the burden of the disease, but also to address its root causes. And this is important for the social and economic determining factors. This is not very well documented yet, but inequalities and biases in health intervene at all stages of the healthcare pathway, be it in prevention, diagnosis, and treatment. In the design of messages, it is important to see whether these messages contain stereotypes or if they don't take into account the social reality. In the collection of medical data, we will be able to build the algorithms for diagnosis. And if the women are not sufficiently represented, the tool will not be adapted for half of the population. And this data, the day of tomorrow, will fuel AI solutions. And finally, also in terms of governance and follow-up, we know that women are underrepresented. In this framework, we are all going to focus on what we call sexual and reproductive health and maternal and civil in child health, because these are real challenges for countries which have limited resources. Let us remember the data concerning maternal mortality. At the end of 2020, the WHO estimates that there were 287,000 maternal deaths, and 95% of which occurred in low- and middle-income countries in sub-Saharan Africa and Asia. So there is an enormous gap, and a lot of efforts must be deployed to improve access to health for for these women. What about the digital systems in all this? It may be a solution, but it can also be a factor of exclusion. There is what we call the digital divide between the North and the South and between men and women. There are about 900 million women who do not have access to internet, and two-thirds of them live in low or middle-income countries. So the main question is, how do we make sure that the digital solutions of today and tomorrow do not duplicate the existing barriers, but on the contrary, they enable us to fight against the barriers, they increase women's autonomy, and to combat health problems. So these issues we are going to debate upon today, and as we are at the time of Nobel Prize winner ceremonies, Einstein used to say, if I had 1 hour to save the world, I would take 55 minutes to define the problem and 5 minutes to find the solutions. So saving the world is not possible for us today, but we can contribute to the definition of the problems and to advance our cause. I wish you all an excellent conference, as participative as possible, and I thank you for your attention.